In the last episode of Naughty Nook, the surf was pumping and Beef got to have all the fun.
Been waiting a long time for this moment. Finally, we got some swell. I'm gonna go get a wave for all you guys watching back home. You!
As the swell dropped under 2 foot, it was my turn to have a go.
Beef just can't handle being so surfed out if I haven't gotten in the water too.
Can't handle it.
You're too nice.
Trying to break. What do you think of the conditions on offer here, babe?
2 foot and offshore. It's heaven.
This is Jay Baby's kind of day. So we've got a walk out on this little reef here, but it goes to sand and then it goes to reef again. Jay Baby's got this. She's good. At the back here, it's a solid 1 foot of swell. High tide, Jana's at the back. A little bit scared of the reef. It's not that deep, look. But she's never gonna hit it in this size swell. And I'm hanging in here to film her. I'm trying to get her to commit. She's pulled back on a few already, but. Ooh, yes, get up, no!
Oh, baby.
Go, baby, it's perfect. Yes, 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 baby, you're on! Yes, oh, baby, that was a good one. Look at the wall on it. So I'm telling Jana that the key to successfully surfing 2 foot waves is just like big waves, you've got to be calm, confident, and committed. And if you do that, you should be right. There's nothing for her to worry about right now. She's really scared of hitting this reef. It's kind of sharp, but it's pretty protected right now. It's high tide. Here we go, set's coming. What's she gonna do? The moment of truth. Go, go, go! Yes! Whee!
Nice. Don't do any turns. Just go and try and be like, not go too shallow. But hey,
it's all part of the fun. It's all about resetting and refreshing.
Beautiful to be out here.
With calm sea conditions, it was the perfect opportunity for us to explore some of the reefs around Elbow Key.
Check out what we got here. Winds are backed off. Boats are sitting pretty, anchors are set well and truly. Sun's shining, solar power's pumping into the batteries. We've got our little dinghy loaded up with some diving gear. We're gonna go check out this, I saw it on Navionics. It's like a navigation hazard that you gotta be aware of. It's a sunken barge, and I looked it on the charts and it's just a little exclamation mark, like nothing. And then I read up on it and apparently there's this sunken barge about 3 feet below the low tide line. And it's like 50 foot long by 20 foot wide or something. It's big, and rumor has it there's some good fish around it. So we're gonna go and try and catch some dinner. We're gonna try and find this wreck. We've got the GPS coordinates for it, so we're gonna go check it out. And if we play our cards right and the gods are in our favor, we're gonna have some dinner maybe tonight if we're lucky. So I'm pretty pumped. We've got Revery over here. They're gonna be joining us. Debra and Evan, they got their little dinghy with their little 15 horse Suzuki on the back. And she hammers. They're gonna beat us if it's a race.
Probably get a head start.
Yeah, we should probably start getting going because these guys are taking... Oh, here we go. Evan's making a move.
We have movement.
Evan's got his fishing rod out. He's serious about this. He's going to trawl a lure on the way there. Hang on a minute. That gives us an idea.
All right. Let's get at it.
Another high five. Get in the naughty nook.
Oh my gosh, I'm a high five fiend.
What do you got
I
for
put
Brecky?
David Putty to shame.
All right, classic. High five. A chimp's all right. High five. Hot color. High five. High five.
David Putty. High five. Seinfeld. I get it.
But I got the big camera out. Last time I took the big camera out, my mast snapped and couldn't go snorkeling, which was a tragedy because it was beautiful. So hopefully it's nice and I can, swim around with my big camera again. It's been a while.
Yeah, are your gun's going to be able to hold it?
I've been doing my push-ups.
She has been doing her push-ups, I've seen her. She's been very good. I've done nothing in that regard. Just drinking beers. All right, we'll keep you posted. And surfing, had a surf this morning, it was pretty fun. Alrighty. Barge, we found the sunken barge. It's just here, the water's crystal. It's like gin clear water. Hopefully there's a couple of little fish around the edges, but hopefully underneath it there's
vodka.
Some I want to get one of those Nassau gropers, you know, them with the bands on the side. Good chewing those ones. That's what we're after, but anything will do. J baby can't wait, she's already in, she's not even waiting for me. Look at her, she's got a big R2D2.
So this happened on the way home. What do we have here, Beef?
Well, we managed to spear this nice little groper here, Nassau groper. He's kind of like a coral trout in Australia, but he's a bit of a different colour, but same head and everything. And I shot him through there, right in the side. Would you look at that?
That's a big hole.
And then on the way home, we were trolling a lure, and then it went off. And then this bad boy ended up jumping aboard, and then as I brought him onto the boat, his hook pierced the inflatable dinghy. So we sprung a leak and it was bubbling up water, so it took me a while to get it off, and then we came home and we quickly put the dinghy on the davits to get it out of the water, because now I'm going to have to patch a hole.
So we got a bit of work to do, but,
so
hey.
Got a bit on, but hey, we're eating fish.
What are you going to eat tonight?
Maybe this groper, this Nassau groper. I've always wanted to try one and he looks delicious.
you, Mr. Fish.
Thank you for your life. These guys are gonna be tasty.
Turn. You think?
Susie, thanks for raising a guy who knows how to cook good fish.
Oh, I just got trolled by these fishes.
Ooh, ah. Excited? Excited?
Yeah, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers!
What are you drinking? The whole bottle. That's my girl.
What have we got here?
Cheers, Beefy.
Cheers. What do we got here?
Salad and spaghetti squash and kale.
What's spaghetti squash?
Fish bites and tortillas. Bon appetit, everyone.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Introducing Debra, Evan, and Sadie Jane and their version of the American Dream. If you've been watching our videos, you probably would have seen their amazing faces popping up in a couple of episodes, and you might have been wondering a little bit about them, who they are, what they're about, what makes them tick. So I sat down with them for a couple of minutes and chewed the fat with them. So hope you guys enjoy. They're one of the most amazing couples that we lucked out to be on the same dock with, that we ended up cruising with. They're such a great buddy boat, and it's important to have these kinds of friends out there in the high seas. So we love you guys and we miss you, and thanks for everything.
Where are you going with your long face pulling down? Don't hide away like an ocean that you can't see, but you can smell and the sound of waves crash down. I am no Superman. I have no reasons for you. I am no hero, oh, that's for sure. But I do know one thing. It's where you are, it's where I belong. I do know.
Normal people.
Yeah, well, no, not at all.
Not normal people. I don't think so. I think we pretty much defy normal.
So there's a long story and short story?
Yes.
Yeah,
so,
which one do you want?
We'd like both.
Okay, well.
We want the most interesting version.
Okay, yeah. So short story is we wanted to travel the world and go diving.
Yes.
And we ended up on a sailboat.
The 8-year plan that ran into 9 years. And so then... We bought this boat, got it ready, and here we are, just doing it.
Mostly ready.
Biggest challenge owning this boat was complete repower, unexpectedly.
Yes. We were supposed to have left, really, we were going to leave last year with a water maker, and that was already a year past when we had planned to leave. And then we ended up leaving this year instead without the water maker, but with a brand new electric engine.
How did it go for you guys? How's an electric engine?
It's great.
Yeah.
It really, once we sorted the issues out with, but no, it's
but it's fixed now.
And it's a sailboat, so
we sail.
It's working out really, really well.
Yeah.
And our carbon I won't say our carbon footprint because I'm not that green, but our emissions, right? We're still running a diesel engine when we motor a long time, but it only burns a quarter gallon an hour to a third of a gallon an hour, as opposed to a gallon or more an hour, and so it's better.
Yeah. And that's not the only thing that you guys have done that's a little bit different on your boat. What else have you got?
Our composting head.
Oh, yeah.
So it's funny.
It's not composting. It's desiccating.
It's a desiccating. It's a dry head. People call them composting, and they don't actually compost. They desiccate.
Because if they composted, they'd actually be gross,
yeah,
in my opinion.
Yeah, because compost kind of stinks. But
so that would sound to the average person back home like a long drop or something. Like, it would sound like your poo just piles up, and then you got to empty it. Is that what happens?
Eventually, sure.
Sort of, but not quite that.
So it uses, for those that don't know, it uses cocoa peat, a byproduct of...
It's coconut husk.
It's coconut husk, and they grind it up, and it's reusing the byproduct of harvesting coconuts. Use that in a... and there's a vent, right? And it dries out. So it separates the liquids from the solids.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing, is the solids and the liquids are separated when you go to the bathroom.
One in one tank, one in the other.
And it does it by itself. You don't have to fiddle with anything to make that happen. It just happens.
Yep.
And then your solids go into where the coconut husk is, and it gets churned whenever you're done. It has a little crank on it. You don't have to look at it. It's all good.
For long.
And then,
you're a little more up close and personal with your stuff than in a normal North American or North American toilet.
It's
or
really not that
Western
big a
toilet.
If you've gone to the bathroom in a porta potty, and if you've gone to the bathroom in a porta potty after a concert, this is a billion times better.
Yeah. So,
and then it just has a hose that's like a pool hose that runs up, and it has a fan that runs all the time, and it keeps air circulating, and it dries out, and it turns literally into dirt.
When it comes to, Jenny, you asked about emptying it, right?
Yeah.
You do have to empty it eventually, the solid tank, but when you do, it literally smells
just dirt.
Like potting soil.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it's not an issue.
And we were told that. And
you're getting some
time. I happen to.
Hang on. We'll pause for a sec because we're getting.
Yeah. So, as I was saying, I do find it amusing that I had to convince him of doing the airhead. He literally looked at me and said, "Okay, that might be a little too granola for me." I did install it on this one. My dad helped me. I was gonna do it myself, and then my dad happened to be here, and then there was no way he was gonna let me do it by myself. Yeah. So,
good old fashioned Texan dad, eh?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he is a West Texas cowboy.
That's awesome.
Makes her the interesting mix. Her mom's from Queens, and her dad's from West Texas.
Yep.
So it's she.
I had no chance.
I want to meet them.
They're fun.
They are.
So what do your parents think of you guys doing this? And in fact, what do your kids think of you guys doing this?
The kids, they don't really know any different because they grew up knowing that this is what we were planning on doing.
Yeah.
Because they were young enough when we came of this idea. It wasn't until a few years later and they were older that we suddenly went, oh man, we should have just taken, we should have done it with them, like right then. Like, we should have bought the boat right then and taken the kids with us and taken off.
My mom's all about it. My parents were travelers. They've been on all seven continents at least twice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because they've been to Antarctica twice. When they retired, they just decided they were going to go travel, and that's what they did, and this is just an extension of that. So my mom will be 85 this year, and she wants to come out and do this with us.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, getting in and out of a dinghy. She goes, I can do it. But that's my mom too, so she's a tough old bird. But your parents are
well, they're coming around to it.
Yeah,
they've been dead set against it since day one. So for 10 years, they think we're crazy. But, I mean, that's typical from
most people.
Yeah,
most people's experiences most cruisers have the same experiences.
Yeah.
Like, everybody just thinks they're crazy.
And the other people think you're, you know, filthy rich.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
And we're not.
Neither.
We're
not filthy.
We own a small house still in Indianapolis that the kids rent from us, but this is it. We're by no means rich. We're on a fixed income, and we just make it work. So,
yep.
Yeah.
We work and we save, and we work hard, we play hard.
Yeah.
It's a song, isn't it?
Yeah. These guys are big Dave Matthews Band fans. You could say tragics. Could you? They've got Dave Matthews shirts, flags.
Dave Matthews.
What is it? I mean, there's so many good bands, and you guys are music. Like,
yeah,
we're
do.
Big music
we're
people.
Big music people. EDM and Dave Matthews. It's like, I love Vegas! And this treehouse. It's kind of...
It's an illness.
We might have a little bit of an obsession.
Yeah. Fire dancers on
the transom. We have fire dancers on our transom. So maybe
that. Up until this past year, every show was different. Every single show was different.
We would go to 7 shows, 9 shows, 10 shows, every concert season.
And it's all different.
And it's different every show.
What's your favorite Dave song?
Which There's is my no. favorite child?
It's a good song.
But it's also a community.
Yeah.
And that's another huge draw. I mean, you can be, you know, a huge fan of whatever band, but to have that kind of community. I mean, when the kids were little, I used to teach them to look for fire dancer stickers on cars and let them know if you're ever in trouble, you find that person. That person will help you.
Yep.
Because that's the kind of community it is. Yeah.
Don't go look for a policeman. No, God, no. No. But go look for somebody with... Go like, look for a total stranger. Find, some hippie.
If you can't find some other authority figure...
Go find like, some hippie with a fire dancer and, you know, they'll help you out.
What do you do for work, Debra? You've got a pretty cool job.
I am a sign language interpreter.
Can you give us a little demo?
It's funny. Ooh, turtle!
What's the sign for turtle?
Turtle!
Nice.
Like here's a shell and
what's
here's
shark?
His head poking out. Shark.
Oh yeah, that's universal.
Yeah
pretty much.
Yeah. Whale?
Whale. Like their tail coming up out of the water.
Oh, I like that. Whale.
Incidentally, it's also the sign for SeaWorld.
Because they keep whales in captivity. And
what about...
We won't talk about that.
No.
What about fish?
Fish.
Not this
fish.
One?
You can do that. We'll know what you're talking about, but yeah. I mean, people think that we're rich because we're able to do something like this. Sure. Cruisers know that that's not the case. You just budget differently.
Yeah. The key is this, and it's interesting that talking with you and Beef, the Australian dream and the American dream and probably Canadian dream, exactly the same, right?
Right.
You work, you buy a house, you get in debt, and you just... are a slave to that debt for the rest of your life until the house is paid off, and then you're old and you have a house paid off.
What I tell
people when they ask me is you just to break that cycle, right? Yourself out of debt, and if you're not a slave to debt, it's your money. Whatever you make is your money. It's nobody else's, and so yeah, we discovered that we're in the same trap as. You know, 10 years ago, we were in that same trap, but something clicked in our minds.
I can't help but notice you guys are sporting some nice jewelry, and a little birdie told me you make these yourself.
Do you
really?
Can I get a jewelry? I'm like, I don't know what I have on.
Dream, courage.
Yeah. Oh, this was actually a set of 7, and they're all a little bit different, so I don't know what's on this one.
Live.
Live.
Yep.
And living, then living Evan's dream. Got a really cool.
Yeah,
that's yeah. recently made.
I made that one too. And this one.
And you found that on a beach?
Yep, I found the stone on a beach. Like the jade I had, but
yeah,
the stone I found on the beach, and so I made that for him.
You're a nicer wife than I would have been had Beef left me for 2 weeks.
So that's
debacle.
Another thing, right? And this is where we think that we've thought that we want to go with our blog, and if we do a vlog, is you know, the unvarnished, this is what went wrong. This
yeah.
is, and so, long story short, we drowned our refrigerator compressor on the way to the Bahamas. We dumped 65 gallons of fresh water into the bilge, and we didn't know. And it sloshed around the bilge where our refrigerator compressor is.
And you might ask.
For 13 hours.
Why didn't your bilge pump take care of that? Well, funny thing, it wasn't on.
Because we had, I was showing her the day before all this happened how to manually pump out the bilge. And if those that know, those that don't know, when you push the switch to manual and let go, it goes back to off, not back to auto. And yeah.
That's
so,
a hard lesson.
It was a hard lesson.
The self-sufficiency.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like right now. Sitting in the cockpit with my dog, and the sun is starting to go down kind of
and
over here.
And it's not a rolly anchorage.
It's not a rolly anchorage.
Because we've
it's
had
actually
some...
really nice and smooth right now. There's just like a light breeze happening, and I can just go down and get a drink if I want it, and I can just jump in the water right here if I want to.
Yep.
Because the water's clear, and I can see the bottom, and I know that there's nothing gross down there.
I don't know. When we can get out in a good breeze, because this is the sailor part of it, right? When we came down from Great Guana to Elbow Key the other day. We had 15 knots of wind on almost a beam reach. So it was and our boat Revery, she beam reach is her best point of sail, but just off of beam reach, and it was great sailing. And the only thing better would have been if there was a fish on the line.
And we do a toast to Poseidon every time we catch a fish.
Yeah.
Take a shot.
Is it Poseidon or Neptune?
Both.
Maybe we should do both.
One's a Greek, one's a Roman, right?
Oh, okay. I need to start doing both.
Yeah.
So when are you happiest? When your rail's in the water?
Nah, almost the rail in the water. The rail in the water is a little too stiff. When I'm happiest, I get up in the morning, have a cup of coffee, and it's beautiful like this. I can jump in the water. I've got my beautiful bride next to me. I'm happy. Happiest doing this. The nice thing is, we're on this stuff, we're of the same mind, right? This is what we want to do.
Both of us? Yeah.
This is what we want to do. How we go about it on a day-to-day basis is a little different, but this is what we want to do. We want to be on the water. We're both water babies, even though I'm an earth sign.
Well, we really lucked out being on E-Dock with you guys. You're the best buddy boat any cruiser could have ever wanted, especially a first-time cruiser. Yeah. We owe you guys so much, and we're so happy we get to share this with you.
Yep. You have no idea how much we actually owe you guys.
No way!
No, for real, because, and we've talked about this a couple of times, people show up in your lives
at certain times
for certain reasons, and timing is always right. And I am thoroughly convinced that we would have been still kicking around on E-Dock
trying to get this little bit right.
Oh, we can't go quite yet because this isn't perfect. Yeah. And you guys showed up, and you were the first cruisers that were ready to go and like amping to get out of there, not just liveaboards on the dock.
Annoying shout out, putting our washing on the line.
Yeah.
Which we love living aboard, and of course we love E-Dock because, I mean, it's E-Dock.
Awesome.
Yeah,
God.
Awesome people, yeah.
It's the party dock.
Shout out to E-Dock!
We'll be back.
We'll be back really soon, guys. But it was like you guys really gave us a big kick in the pants to like, okay, shit or get off the pot.
Yep. Whether you knew it or not.
Whether you knew it or not, you guys were a huge like kick in the pants for us. Like, let's get moving.
Yeah.
And then when we realized that we could really be on the same timeline and we could cross together.
Yeah.
Well, you guys really stepped up to the challenge. You did. You had lots of stuff going on, and we were just focused on the boat. You know.
Yeah.
We had a bit of an advantage in that sense.
Yeah. But what it forces you to do, and this is, I'll leave this with people that are thinking about doing this, even to people that have their boats and haven't left yet, is just do the important things, right? Make sure that the mast stays up, the keel stays down, the water stays out, and the people are on board, right?
You're never going to be ready.
Like, and we
100% ready. Never.
If you were to look around my boat, which, God, I don't want you to, we don't have
our
a ceiling.
Beautiful.
We don't have a ceiling in the boat right now, but we didn't need a ceiling in the boat, right?
The headliner's down because we were doing work, and it was like we didn't
know. You had to rewire for your engine.
We had to rewire for the engine, and we had to take the handrails.
There were some leak issues.
We had to take the whole headliner down, so we didn't put it back up yet. Why? Because we didn't have time.
We didn't need to. It didn't.
We'll get to it later.
We got to the Bahamas and are enjoying life, and so what that we don't have a headliner.
Yeah.
Nobody cares.
Yeah, nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
Except us.
I love that about you guys.
Yeah. Whatever. Right? And that was kind of a mind shift for me over the past 2 years is, I thought, everything's got to be perfect. I'm very type A, right? Everything's got to be perfect. Just the important stuff matters. The other crap doesn't. Right? I'll get to it. We might have a headliner when we leave this fall. Who knows? We might not. There's other more important things. Probably will.
Oh, you guys are an inspiration, honestly.
Thanks. Yeah.
Love
you guys are too. All right. Whatever.
Baby,
love you.
Love you too.
Love you guys.